216-578-1007 if you want to join us live. 800-348-1007. I think the phones are finally working. You can just as easily text 35192. If you're listening on the iHeartRadio app, leave quick messages there as well. Hey, Woody.
Hello.
Woody, what's going on?
Woody, what's going on? Hey, I had a day off from work, sir, and I want to wish Cody a very happy 30th.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Thank you.
How's your day, sir?
Poundcake, how has your day been so far? I know you were really in your feels last night about the last night of your 20s. By the way, who was your first fap in your 30s?
Mary asked me the same thing, but I haven't fapped in my 30s yet. I only fapped in my 20s.
Sorry, who was your last fap of your 20s?
It was someone very deserving and now deceased.
Me. Oh, the Queen of England.
No.
Oh, my goodness. Very deserving. Oh, because he was hot. He's out there whacking it to the Queen of England.
No.
As timely as today's headlines, you can count on Poundcake for that.
Yeah, Aaron Hernandez got the last fap of my 20s. I hope he's proud.
Now, did you picture him after he had hanged himself? Or
how do you murdered somebody.
Right. How do you picture him? Like with blood in his hands from having murdered someone?
No, walking into court with those newly bought veneers and, you know, in his little suit, waiting for his judgment.
Yeah. Oh. Well, there you have it, Woody.
Yeah, ironically enough, my first fap of Cody's birthday was the Queen of England.
Right. I feel like that's a good.
Sure, why not? Right. A 21-gun salute, if you will.
So I haven't had my first fap of my 30s yet. So it's still up for debate. I still have time. So send me your submissions, everyone.
There you go. Poundcake at alancoxshow.com.
Yep.
And he'll take them. Well, how are you spending your day, Woody?
Yard work. And I did a little shopping. I got some steaks for the grill tonight.
Yeah.
And I have to go to the package store to pick up some beverages.
Oh, boy. All right. Well, listen, it sounds like you've got a full dance card. I won't keep you any longer.
Well, thank you, sir. You guys have a great day. And once again, happy birthday to the Code Man.
Oh, there you go. Okay, thank you. There's Woody out in Willoughby. You know, I bet Woody's going to be front and center when you guys do that garage bar gig. That's right in his neck of the woods.
Yeah.
He's right out there on the lake. You're going to look out across that stage, and you're going to see Woody front row.
Hopefully.
Yep.
September 17th.
Get Guardians.
Tickets at BillSquire.com.
There you go. Guardians lose last night. They dropped that final game in the series against the Royals in Kansas City, and the Royals avoid the sweep. 2-1 was the final last night. Guardians take tonight off, and they'll head up to Minneapolis to play the Twins tomorrow night, 8:10. So tomorrow, Saturday, and Sunday, that series against the Twins, who are a very good ball team. And they've announced, by the way, I hope that we see a lot of things from this kid. They've announced that Tristan McKenzie is the Guardians' nominee for the Roberto Clemente Award, which is a very prestigious award in Major League Baseball. If you've never seen this Tristan McKenzie kid play, I mean, I saw him when he set apparently some franchise record. It was Memorial Day last year. The White Sox were in town, and we took our daughter to her first baseball game. And Tristan McKenzie, I think, was a kid who had been toiling in the minor leagues, and they called him up. And he was wild to watch. He was making mincemeat out of my White Sox, but to watch this kid play. And now I don't know if he has had uneven results since then. He set the franchise record for the most consecutive strikeouts. He knocked out 8 White Sox hitters in a row. And so it was fun to watch him. So he's the guy that the Guardians are putting up as a nominee for the Roberto Clemente Award. Of course, you'll recall Bob Clemente was with the Pittsburgh Pirates. Very famous. Died in a plane crash. That's why they called him the Big Bopper of baseball. I don't know if anybody called him that, but they easily could call him that.
Was it Thurman Munson that also died in a plane
Thurman
crash?
Thurman Munson died in a plane crash. Something like that, right? Was he with the Mets or who was he with?
The Yankees.
The Yankees. Thurman Munson, the pride of Bacon, Ohio, died today at the age of 32. Yeah, he died young. And he died right out here, right in our backyard.
There's another pitcher that this is probably like 2002 or maybe 2004, 2005. He was flying around in New York City and crashed into a building.
There you go.
Who was that?
Don't know. I remember. I know that they were trying to get him to stop flying his plane because they're like, something's going to go wrong here. So the whole team's freaking out because they don't want to lose Thurman Munson. And so they were like, well, this was the threat, by the way. And he's a local guy. They go, just trade him to the Indians.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll get him to stop flying. Except he wanted to come home to the Indians. So I'm not sure what they were thinking. But yes, Thurman Munson died today in a, I don't know, whenever that was, late 70s.
Corey Lydell was the one that I was thinking of.
Okay.
And he was with an instructor and flew into a building.
And then there was that kid that died in that boat crash a few seasons ago. That like big time pitcher in Miami.
Fernandez, I want to say.
Something like that. I don't know. There's a lot of Fernandezes in Major League Baseball. It's hard to keep them.
Going back to the Indians in the 90s had a couple players that died in a boat crash.
Mm-hmm. These damn boat crew. When are these ball players going to, why, they're toys? You know, I was living in Pittsburgh when Roethlisberger crashed his motorcycle with no helmet. I mean, this guy's got a head like a hot air balloon, so who cares? But,
Dummies, holy cow. A lot of them.
They're like, you know, what was his name that used to be here? The allegedly rapey guy.
Kellen Winslow?
Trevor Bauer,
okay.
Who, like, cut his pinky or something on a drone.
Kellen Winslow's the convicted rapey guy.
Oh, okay, well.
Yeah. He was raping old ladies.
Old ladies?
Yeah.
Yikes.
Yeah. That dude was messed up.
I guess so.
He would just, like, openly watch pornography on the plane and, like, play with himself in front of everybody. Like,
he had mental issues.
He was very mentally gone, yeah.
Yeah. You know, it's not on the front page anymore, but it doesn't mean that's not happening. The war in Ukraine is still going on.
I was thinking about that just the other day. I was like, no one is covering this.
Well, it's still on the news. It's just we are not paying attention to it because apparently people took down their blue and yellow striped social media posts. But it is still happening. We just committed another couple $1 billion to their assistance. But I think about this in the same way as if you watch those floods in Pakistan that put 2/3 of the country underwater, a big, big deal. But that leaves 1/3 of the country completely unaffected. And so when you think about Ukraine, I think we have this notion that the entire country is a war-torn hellscape now. And it's not necessarily the case because they're still doing things that we would do. They're still having fun fairs, right? You don't think about this because when they show you stuff on the news, they show them pulling bodies out of rubble and things like that. But I was watching this story about this fun fair that was happening in Ukraine. And the reason it was on the news is because they let a kid play with a grenade launcher that I guess they thought was inert, but it wasn't. And so this kid accidentally fired off an anti-tank weapon. At like a fun fair, you know, like when you go, the local fire department's going to pull the trucks out and the kids can go sit inside and, you know, come on out and see how you're, these fun fairs. Get your face painted, kids. I don't know if they're doing any of that, but in Ukraine, they let you touch the grenade launchers.
Hmm.
And obviously, everybody at the fair thinks they're under attack. So they start freaking out and scrambling. There's a good clip going around of a woman that was being interviewed about the fair, and the grenade goes off.
And yeah, and you see her just wince. Like, she's just like, what the?
Yeah.
That's wild.
Yeah, right. Hey, who let the 10-year-old boy grab the anti-tank weapon? So, again, I guess I didn't think that they were having, like, fun social times in Ukraine.
Also, you think
because we think the
people,
entire nation is, you know, children in Cherniv were allowed to play with weapons. Now, again, these are probably kids who grow up with weapons. Well, yeah, that too. Right. Hey, we're going to need warm bodies for a long time to come. What are you, 10? We're still going to need you when you're 18.
Did anybody get hurt?
Three people were injured.
Okay. No one died.
Well, he and no, I don't think so. He and his 12-year-old brother needed urgent medical care, but I didn't see that anybody died. But yeah. Now, I got to tell you, I remember going to like county fairs and things of this nature when I was a kid, and I don't know if they do it anymore. But they used to have things like this. They'd have like, you know, here's a gun. Here's a, they'd show them to you, and here's an old something or other. Or they'd be setting off explosives out in a field. You know, my extended family on my mother's side, which was the only side we knew, they were mostly rural people. We were the outliers in my mother's family in that we were city people. But most of my extended family were rural people. And so when we would visit them, we would go to these kinds of events. You'd be like, ride the tractor, you know. I had my first helicopter ride at one of those things. That's a lot of fun. And we didn't have anything like this. If I was 10 years old and they had a sign-up sheet for, hey, play with the RPG, I probably would have gone over and done that. So you certainly can't blame the kid.
Right. Well, it's definitely not on the kid. It's ridiculous that they would have live ammunition anywhere on site.
I guess
pretty insane.
I guess that they didn't think that it was
on site.
I guess they didn't think that it was alive. You know, with as much ammunition.
But it's also one of those things, like, even if you don't think it, like, you have to double check. You don't just go, I'm pretty sure that there are no grenades
yes.
in that grenade launcher.
You like, stick your face over the barrel and you mm-hmm. make sure there's nothing
yeah,
in
look,
there.
Exactly. That's the safe
hey, this
way
is
to
empty.
Handle it.
Think we're okay. You got nothing to worry about, kid. Just look in there and is everything okay? Hey, is that kid touching the RPGs again, or is that we need to get that from him? I think his brother's over there too. Anyway, we're doing the face painting over here if you kids want to. And we got some hot, fresh cherry pies over here in the sill. Boy, I should do something like that at the, what's the thing you guys went to?
Yep. The air show.
Air show.
No. The fair. The
fair?
Didn't you guys go to the Cuyahoga County Fair?
I went to the Lorain County Fair.
Do they do anything like this?
I mean, you were looking for the word for fair, and then you said the fair. What's it called?
No. The place.
Yeah.
There are a lot
what?
Of fairs.
The county fair.
There are tons of county fairs.
Sure.
I was trying to figure out which one you guys went
to. I went to the Cuyahoga one. Cody went to the Lorain one.
Right.
Right. No cherry pies from what I saw.
Any RPGs?
But lots of grenades. Shoot.
Yeah!
You know, like
that's right.
GTL. The Jersey Shore style.
That's right. You got to jump on some of those.
Like the situation's going to jump on some grenades.
Oh, God. We were trying to find things with our daughter's name on it at that Jersey Shore store, the one where they worked.
Mm-hmm.
And they have magnets and they have keychains and things like that. And her name is not a common one, at least not that the spelling.
Really?
Well, it's N-O-R-A-H. Her name has an H. But even the name Nora is not common. You'll see a lot of Bradens and Cadens and Jadens now, and that's fine. But so the only thing we could find was a magnet that says, or I don't know what it is. It says, like, it had two of the girls on there. It had Snooki and then one of the other girls that wasn't JWoww. I don't know who they are.
Sammy.
Maybe. And it said, Meatball Posse or something. Because then they call the dudes meatballs or like...
No, the girls.
The girls are meatballs? Yeah.
That was...
Okay.
Like Snooki's term for them. Meatball girls.
Okay. Why'd they call themselves... I watched that show, but I don't
Snooki
remember.
Snooki was short and thick. Yeah. So
and she called herself a meatball.
I see.
Gotcha. Well, yeah, anyway. So that was all we could find was a magnet on a refrigerator with her name. I think it says Meatball Posse or Meatball Zone or something on there.
Meatball Zone.
Meatball Crossing.
Yeah. Meatball something. I don't even think there was alliteration in it. I don't think it was like Meatball Mamas or anything like that. I don't know.
That's Snooki and Dina. I think it was.
You might be right. Snooki. It was whichever one they kicked off early.
No, they kicked off Angelina, maybe?
Yeah, I think it was Angelina, maybe. Right.
Okay.
I don't know. Anyway. My daughter doesn't even know what that show is, right? We were just looking for something we could show her that had her name on it, and of course she's six, so that's all she cares. That'll be great.
You guys need to teach her American history early, okay?
You mean Jersey Shore?
That is her American
history. Her American history. Mm-hmm. That's our American history. She wasn't even alive for that. That's not her, you know, I mean, that's not going
to
resonate with her.
She needs to know.
That's what I say. I learned a lot of stuff that happened before I was alive. in my history class.
But you don't remember any of it. That's the problem.
But you've been alive for so long now.
You've said many times.
Such an old, washed-up man.
You've said many times that was before my time. You are an old, washed-up man now, and I think, you know, when people say it's good to mind your elders, and maybe you can glean some wisdom from them. Do you have any wisdom as now a grizzled 30-year-old that you can impart to this audience? Anything that occurred to you? Did you stay up until midnight last night? Like a fourth grader?
I went to bed just before midnight, and I was like, oh my gosh. When I open my eyes, everything's going to hurt. I'm instantly going to...
Everything's going to hurt?
Is the reason
does anything
you...
Did anything hurt yesterday?
No,
oh.
But I just assumed everything
I'm
was
51
hurt.
And nothing yeah. hurts on me, so you got a good run still.
Is the reason you didn't have a FAP in your 30s because you just couldn't get it up anymore? Because you're so old?
Everything's broken.
You know, I think I'm trying to save it up for, like, if I get laid in Colorado.
Save it up? What do you think, it's like wine? You got to let it age?
No, I don't want to let it age. I just want it to be, like, you know.
Ferment.
Wait.
What, he did the noise again. He did the sound effect.
You just want to have a big pop.
Quafty.
Yeah, I don't know. Because that's a lot of pressure. Like, my last one is like, all right, I've done, you know, several, a decade worth of fapping in my 20s. This is a big one. I mean, if you pardon the pun, like, this is the first one I'm going to go, and I'm conscious of it, and I don't want to just give it to anybody, so.
So you would rather get laid before you fap, is what you're trying to say.
Correct.
I'll see
what happens.
He wants it to be like...
oh, that's a big load!
So I'm waiting.
He wants it to be like anti-aircraft fire when he gets in there.
Oh, that's a big load!
If the opportunity presents itself, then I may fap, but I would like to just get it in there.
I mean, the opportunity always presents itself to practice some self-love, you know.
Yeah, but I haven't found anybody worthy enough to get this first one.
Huh.
So I thought I wasn't even going to be, other than flying into the airport, I didn't think I would be in Denver during this trip, but apparently we're spending the last day getting dinner there, so I will spend some time going around Denver for a little bit. And I have another friend there, too, that's probably going to meet up with us.
Oh, one of Poundcake's friends is on the phone.
I took a big old swaller out of it, and I was like, uh-oh.
Yep, that'd be me.
It'd be one of his pals on the other side of the weekend. So you guys are going to have dinner in Denver.
We're going to have dinner in Denver. I don't know where. Yeah. We're taking the train from the airport to some place.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. My friend's coming to pick me up, so I don't know how any of this works. I imagine I'm going to be just fine. I'm going to follow the herd and be highly intoxicated and or high.
Okay.
Good for you. What a good birthday weekend.
You should go to there's a cocktail bar in downtown Denver. Not a whole lot of great stuff downtown, but there's a place called the Green Russell, and it's a downstairs kind of speakeasy joint, which always sounds kind of douchey, but it's awesome. If you can get your friends to go to Green Russell, you'll have a good time. Because I know you like it to be like swanky and kind of.
I don't, because I don't.
It's got that look, but it doesn't have that feel.
Okay.
Yeah, you can get some pops there.
I'm down for anything. I know everything's going to be expensive. So I'm just going to be like, oh, it's my birthday. I don't know. I don't want to spend that much money. You know, I'm on a diet. I'm trying to cut the calories.
Are you saying that you're going to try to guilt other people in picking up the tab for you?
You knew that. You didn't even have to say that.
Yeah,
you knew that's what his plan was.
I don't have the conscience to guilt someone.
Because there's strength in numbers. He figures he's going to be with so many people that the odds are much higher
if
that somebody will go.
Each of them buys him a drink.
Everybody chips in, or somebody goes, don't worry, I'll get it.
I'm just going to sit there and not have anything in front of me and see how long I have to wait until someone buys me.
He's
gonna be sipping seductively with his own friends. Not even
sipping.
He's
gonna look around with puppy dog eyes. Like, Cody, you're not drinking. He's like, oh, I'm trying to save money. Like,
that
sucks.
I'll get it. Yeah,
no,
I want every one of them to go. Oh,
like,
that sucks.
Man,
yeah.
I'm sorry about that.
You'd have so much more fun here if you were rich like us.
It's all right. Drinking's not for everybody, man. You'll still have a good time.
Puppy dog eyes. He's got it figured out, though, boy. He's got it figured out.
And he'll get
30,
his way too.
You're a grown man.
Yeah. But he'll get his way.
I know.
He's an old man. He's
30. A mooch. He's an old man mooch.
Mm-hmm.
Leave me alone. Everyone has
mooch
their
doesn't
ways.
Know an age, though. You can be a mooch at any age.
I got uncles still living with my mom.
I think mooches might be my least favorite thing.
Wait, your uncle's living with your mom now?
Yes.
That's new. You never talked about that.
Why would I talk about that?
Why wouldn't you
well,
talk
you brought
about
it up
that?
Now, so you're talking about it now.
Well, yeah. That's because they're about to get out. So it's fine.
This is your mom's brother?
Yep.
I guess it would have to be.
Not his dad's brother.
Right. Well, I don't know. Familial. Poundcake's going to be back in the high life, Bill. Love it's going to be Stevie Winwood. Saw him at Red Rocks.
We got Winwood. We got Hall & Oates today. That's right. Great day.
The Queen dying is the greatest thing to happen to this show musically in some time, even though none of those songs have anything to do with her. But also a cliffhanger, as we just found out that Mary's least favorite person is a mooch.
I hate them.
And yesterday it was people who laugh at bad comedy.
They weren't my least favorite people. They just aggravate me.
Mooches are your least favorite person.
They might be my least favorite person.
Type of people.
Type of people. Correct me.
All right, listen, I'm going to take a break and we'll dig into some of that when we return. 35192 if you want to text for something. AlanCoxShow.com. Want to watch live, you can do it there. And listen anywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
The Alan Cox Show. On 100.9.